সালামু আলাইকুম অ্যান্ড ভেরি গুড ইভিনিং। যুক্তরাজ্য সহ পৃথিবীর যে যেখানে বসে এনটিভি ইউরোপের রেগুলার প্রোগ্রাম কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্স দেখছেন, আপনাদের সবাইকে শুভেচ্ছা সহ স্বাগতম বরাবরের মতো। আজকেও আপনাদের সাথে আছি আমি, আদনান পাভেল। আপনারা যারা রেগুলারলি কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্স দেখেন, আপনারা জানেন কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্স আপনাদের অনুষ্ঠান, আপনাদের নিয়ে অনুষ্ঠান। আমরা সবসময় চেষ্টা করি এই অনুষ্ঠানে এমন সব টপিকে কথা বলতে বা এমন সব অর্গানাইজেশনকে নিয়ে কথা বলতে যারা কিনা ব্রিটিশ বাংলাদেশি কমিউনিটি বা বাংলাদেশি কমিউনিটিতে প্রভাব ফেলছে এবং অদূর ভবিষ্যতে প্রভাব ফেলতে পারে, আজও তার ব্যতিক্রম নয়। আজকে আমরা কথা বলবো নিউ প্রাইম মিনিস্টার, নিউ ব্রিটিশ প্রাইম মিনিস্টার অ্যান্ড হিজ ক্যাবিনেট, এবং এটার ইম্প্যাক্টটা কী আমাদের ব্রিটেনের ন্যাশনাল পলিটিক্সে এবং আমাদের লোকাল পলিটিক্সে, আমরা যারা ইস্ট লন্ডনের বা লন্ডনের বিভিন্ন এরিয়াতে বসবাস করি, বা আপনারা যারা আজকে যুক্তরাজ্যের বিভিন্ন শহর থেকে আমাদেরকে দেখছেন, আপনাদের কমিউনিটিতে এটার ইম্প্যাক্টটা কী? নিউ প্রাইম মিনিস্টার ব্রিটেনকে কী দিতে যাচ্ছে বা ওনার ক্যাবিনেট কতটা অফার করতে পারে ব্রিটেনকে, আমরা তা নিয়ে আজকে কথা বলবো। এবং অ্যাজ অলওয়েজ আমরা সবসময় চেষ্টা করি আমাদের কমিউনিটির ইম্পর্টেন্ট ব্যক্তিবর্গ বা ওই পার্টিকুলার টপিকে যাদের এক্সপার্ট ওপিনিয়ন আছে ওনাদেরকে নিয়ে আমাদের প্যানেলিস্টটা সাজানোর জন্য। আজও তার ব্যতিক্রম নয়, আমার হাতের ডান পাশে আছেন জেনাব আতিক রহমান, হি ইজ ফর্মার চেয়ার অফ ইস্ট হ্যাম কনজারভেটিভ পার্টি। থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ ফর জয়নিং আস।
থ্যাংক ইউ,
থ্যাংক ইউ। আমার হাতের বাম পাশে আছেন কাউন্সিলর পুরুমিয়া, হি ইজ এ কাউন্সিলর ফ্রম টাওয়ার হ্যামলেটস, লন্ডন বারা অফ টাওয়ার হ্যামলেটস, অ্যান্ড হিজ কনস্টিটিউয়েন্সি ইজ মাইল্যান্ড। থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ ফর জয়নিং আস টুডে। থ্যাংক ইউ, সালামুকুম। আমার হাতে সর্ব বাম পাশে উপস্থিত আছেন জনাব আফজাল সাইদ মুন্না, উনি ডাইভার্সিটি অফিসার, লিবারাল ডেমোক্রেট, নিউহ্যাম, বার্কিং অ্যান্ড ডেগেনহাম এরিয়া। থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ ফর জয়নিং আস টুডে। থ্যাংক ইউ, সালামুকুম। সুপ্রিয় দর্শক, আপনাদের যদি কোনো প্রশ্ন থাকে বা কোনো অভিমত থাকে, আমাদের স্ক্রিনে নিচে যে ফোন নাম্বার আছে বা ইমেল অ্যাড্রেস আছে তাতে আপনারা যোগাযোগ করে আমাদের সাথে কথা বলতে পারবেন, আপনাদের ওপিনিয়ন জানাতে পারবেন। আপনাদের যদি কোনো প্রশ্ন থাকে তাও আপনারা আমাদের প্যানেলিস্টদের কাছে জানতে পারবেন। তো ইফ আই মে স্টার্ট উইথ ইউ আতিক রহমান, জনাব আতিক রহমান, ব্রিটেন হ্যাজ গট ইজ 77th প্রাইম মিনিস্টার বোরিস জনসন, ভেরি ওয়েল নন পার্সোনালিটি। People say that he is not just a political leader, he is rather a celebrity. Everyone knows him, not just in the UK, all across the world, for positive and negative, for various reasons.
Yes.
You as a former chair of Eastern Conservative Party, you are a member, a very active member of Conservative Party. Does Boris give you any sort of optimism what will happen in Brexit Britain?
I think the first thing with Boris Johnson is, as you said, he's very well known. Mm. He's got a very interesting past. Some of it, not all positive. He has said some very controversial things. But we've seen in the last 2 days, and as I've seen during the whole 16 hustings, which I attended, I was part of the Back Boris team. He has set out an agenda, mm-hmm. which he has got people in his cabinet to deliver that agenda. And we've seen his speech on the steps of 10 Downing Street, where he set out this optimistic view of what Britain can achieve. And as we've seen when he addressed the House, he has set out in Parliament that it's Parliament's responsibility, for example, to deliver Brexit. And he wants to see more cross-party work as we move forward to deliver some of the more urgent matters that affect this country. So, for example, the police officers, the NHS, the money going into their big infrastructure projects. So, yes, I'm absolutely excited. He's got a brilliant team behind him, and he's already made a start, and that's what we needed. We needed somebody with a full of energy, full of optimism, got the people to deliver what he wants to achieve, and he's off already.
Right. Thank you so much. You mentioned about police number, that he will increase the police number in order to make Britain's roads safe. Particularly, yes. We know that in London, things are sometime way beyond the control of police. So he clearly recognizes that the number, police number needs to be increased.
Yes.
Do you think the previous Prime Minister made a mistake by cutting those police number? You know, when she was a Home Secretary, when she was Prime Minister,
yes.
Do you think she made a mistake? Is that something he is trying to change? Is that he something recognizes and try to see in a different lens?
I think what Boris what Boris Johnson has realized is the country we were backed a decade ago is not the same country we have now.
Right.
Recently we have seen, you know, the criminal activity. We are now seeing people running around with, you know, 12, 13 inch machetes, cyber bullying. This we didn't have back in those days. It was
the whole prospect, the whole landscape has changed.
The whole landscape has changed. And what we've seen, yes, I think, you know, police numbers were cut and they were cut too far.
So it was a you were saying it was a mistake made by former Prime Minister.
I'm not saying indirectly, I'm saying directly that we cut too many police officers. Austerity was imposed on the country. I know people say it was a political choice, but it really wasn't. The economy was tanking and cuts had to be made. And I've been a long advocate, particularly in 2015 when David Cameron came on and the economy had stabilized. I was a great advocate for saying we must now ease up on austerity and bring back in police officers.
Invest in our services.
Right. 20,000 police officers, you know, is welcome, but along with that, Boris Johnson also mentioned that we now need to pin down and or particularly on serious crimes, whether sexual or otherwise, and the sentence they serve must be on par with the activity that, you know, criminal crime they've committed. So that is the second part, and that's a challenge for our prisons to cope with. Our courts to cope with. So it's not just like, well, here's 20,000 police officers, get on with everything.
There are a few other things behind the scene.
There is a whole strategy behind Boris Johnson. I think that's what differentiates him perhaps from Theresa May.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Councillor Purumia, you are a councillor from Tower Hamlets, London Borough Tower Hamlets, you know, where a big chunk of the total population, they are ethnicity-wise, they are British Bangladeshi. Mr. Atik was saying that Boris Johnson as a prime minister, that creates some sort of optimism for him as a conservative. Does that create any sort of optimism for you as a British national?
No, it doesn't. We have to be clear that Boris Johnson is a millionaire prime minister backed by billionaires. You know, as soon as he became prime minister, he celebrated with a Russian oligarch who's wanted for taking money out of Russia. You know, so that's the kind of friend and associates he has. So billionaires look after themselves, millionaires look after their interests. Our community, the Bangladeshi community in Tower Hamlets, is not made up of millionaires. I haven't come across any billionaires as well. Boris Johnson is not for us.
But you see, he said recently, I think yesterday, day before yesterday, he said that he wants to invest about 3.6 billion for all the cities that been left behind.
You say he made that announcement today.
This is a good thing. Many of the British Bangladeshi people, they may be resident of those particular areas.
I totally agree it's a good thing. But I heard this 5 years ago. George Osborne went to Manchester and said the same thing. Boris Johnson went to Manchester saying the same
thing. Maybe this time he'll implement.
So it's like a car salesman, you know, secondhand car salesman. He talks a good talk. But let's look at the car. You know, in 5 years they haven't delivered anything. It's the same party. It's the same cabinet ministers just reshuffled around. They haven't delivered anything in 5 years. What are they going to deliver in the next five
years? Has Labour got any plan? Has Labour got any plan for all those cities or towns that has been left behind? And they felt very strongly during referendum that the political system no longer...
Labour has a plan. What it is... We have to change the way our economy works. We have to change the way our government works. At the moment, the economy works for those who are doing well and leaving people behind. It was Labour who said the left behind communities. We brought it on the agenda. And we have to change the way our economy works, even in Tower Hamlets. Tower Hamlets is a good example of the British economy. Tower Hamlets has 51% poverty rate, with majority of whom are British Bangladeshis who are in poverty. Yeah, we have the third richest borough in England. We have Canary Wharf. You know, so the money isn't going. It's not being spread.
The economy is working for
the rich people at the top.
That's fine.
And we need to change that. And it's not going to be changed by a millionaire cabinet or ministers backed by billionaires.
There is nothing wrong to be rich.
Or a chancellor who's an ex-banker.
There is nothing
wrong to be rich, but rich people look after themselves. We need to have a government that is reflective of the wider community.
But this is a failure for Labour as well. Labour has failed to win people's vote. Labour has failed to win the last general election.
No, Labour has seen of three Tory prime ministers. You had David Cameron. Right. When Jeremy Corbyn became leader of the opposition, you had David Cameron. Mm-hmm. Now you've got Theresa May. Now you've got Boris Johnson. So we've seen of three Tory prime ministers. Bring the general election on.
Definitely. But British people, they are tired of election. You see, people are tired of election. I am sure you recognize people want things to be done. You know, they have given their mandate. So,
but it's not going to be done under this Tory government. Look at Boris Johnson. What has he done as a mayor of London? You had Ken Livingstone, who, as mayor of London, implemented so many changes. Boris Johnson just adopted Ken Livingstone's plan, which is the Boris spikes, which was Ken Livingstone's plan. And then he didn't do nothing. If you look at London during Boris Johnson's 8 years, you had a lack of housing being built.
If he was not, I understand and I appreciate your point, but if he was not a good mayor, how on earth he won the second term? I mean,
no, because there was.
I mean, historically, we know Labour is a very Labour is a strong Labour field, but then
no, because you've got to look at who his backers were. He was backed by the Evening Standard. The Evening Standard given free at every single railway station. That's free propaganda, funded by a Russian billionaire oligarch who's wanted in Russia.
Okay, thank you. I take your point. Yeah. We'll come back to you.
And you talk about law and order. What about Lebedev? Why don't you send him back to Russia to face?
We will talk more detail about other aspect of his policy, whether he provides some sort of optimism, whether he would be able to deliver Brexit. And he also highlighted that he wanted to work as cross party. He wants to have good relationship with other political party in order to implement differentiate. We'll talk more in detail. Mr. Afzal Said Munna, diversity officer from Lib Dem, you covered a big area, Newham, Barking and Dagenham. Does Boris' leadership give you any sort of optimism, or you think this is the same person, same political party, just this is all good talk, but there is no implementation?
Shubha Shanta viewers, Assalamu alaikum. Thank you very much for inviting me for this very good topic. The thing is, optimism, the word itself, is very positive, right? It sheds lights on everybody's life. It doesn't suit Boris. Number one, if you looked into Boris not becoming the prime minister, since he put himself, his name on the hasting that he wants to be a candidate, each and every single day the newspaper is just publishing that is Boris fit for UK. And I think that is still happening, and my other colleagues are saying the same thing, that is he fit? There is no optimism about him, but yes, I will completely agree with Puruvai that he was saying that it's a very fantastic quality class second-hand car sellers. What he is saying, that is polished. I must have to agree, and I must have to say this, that I was initiated and appreciated.
But as long as he can sell the car, and if it is in a good state, the thing is,
this, we will go in deep of that by explaining things. The only thing I liked about him saying, standing on 10 Downing Street, what he is saying to the whole world, that do not underestimate United Kingdom, which I like. Yes, do not underestimate us, what we can do. But the thing is that, do we have a plan, that what we are saying? What he is saying now, if you want to communalize or generalize Boris as a person, individual, who becomes the prime minister for us, he's a liar. He's a world-class international liar.
Well, every politician is. I mean, Lib Dem is a classical example. Tuition fee is one of the biggest blunders of Lib Dem. Nobody talks about
the behind. The tuition fee was an initiation by the Labour. But if you looked into that, how we worked, and the topics we are talking about, even the prime ministers we are talking about, is all backed by the Brexit. So what is happening in terms of... So, will he be able to deliver? 3 years now, changes of three different politicians, prime ministers, including 77 prime ministers we are having now. 3 years, you haven't delivered the Brexit. And what you said, don't forget, £650 million injections into the NHS. Where are those monies? Right. So if you lied in the beginning, what extra you're going to bring
prime
now?
Minister, the former prime minister, she wasn't able to get her deal sorted from parliament because it wasn't supported by Lib Dem or Labour. So the other political party, they need to take some.
It's
sort
because
of
we do.
Well.
It's because we do not want to have a Brexit. It's because our future.
Maybe we don't want to, but that 52% of the total electorate, they voted for Brexit.
But what about the people's vote? When you looked into the people's vote, which is far more bigger than who other people's has voted, mm-hmm. they have changed their mind. We made a mistake, and I think I said that again in past as well, in one of your programs as mm-hmm. well, that we have been lied. You told me that this is what you're going to do to me, and then when I cast my vote, after that you change. Right. So people voted for Brexit is because you lied, and those are becoming clear.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Very interesting conversation. We need to go for a break. Once we come back from break, then we'll continue having this interesting conversation, whether Boris leadership give any sort of optimism to this nation and to our community. Shubhpriyo Darshak, aajke community matters amra kotha bolchi, new British Prime Minister ebong his cabinet, ei particular topic amra jabo ekta birotite amader sathei thakun.